What's poppin', you guys? Your boy, Mr. THC, man, back at it with a banger. And we got a special guest on the show today. What's up?
Hey, how you doing?
Introduce yourself.
I'm Julie from the Black.
Julie from California. Yo, and we out in Berkeley right now.
Yeah, we are.
We met, like, somewhat of a halfway point, I guess, because she came up from Oakland, I came from Vallejo, and we're here in Berkeley, so.
Yeah.
A lot of traffic to get here. And it was not easy to get here, so I need you guys to destroy the like button for this video, please, because I was stuck in traffic, stressing. Yeah, and subscribe if you haven't subscribed. We're on the road for 600,000 subscribers. I mean, I want to say road to a million, but we got to break 600K first. So let's get to 600,000 subscribers. Subscribe if you haven't already. As you guys can tell by the title of today's video, we're gonna be doing a review. And do you want to show them kind of what you have right here?
So we got some loose leaves. If y'all don't know, they're basically tobacco leaves, but this is a new hype right now, I guess. So we're going to do a review, basically, what's the difference between these and, like, backwoods and shit.
And, like, all the other stuff, right? So you have, like, Swishers, you have, like, the Dutches, you have, like, all those things. So I feel like we're going to give you guys a... It's my first time actually trying them. So this is going to be, like, a genuine review. And this isn't sponsored. So this is going to be just, like, what it is, a raw review. You know what I'm saying?
But if you do want to sponsor, tap in.
Yeah. You want to throw the bag. You feel me? Let me see what we have. We have natural dark leaf. I don't think that doesn't even call my name.
Right.
No. Russian cream. All right. It's kind of more up my alley.
Strawberry dream.
This is the one I actually seen.
Yeah.
Because I've seen this company before. I've seen that one. Yeah. What would you compare that to, like, flavor-wise?
I don't know, because I've never really smoked flavored tobacco. This is, like, the first flavored thing I've smoked. I usually just get original backwoods before I started smoking these. But these are pretty clutch because they're just so much easier and convenient. It's already cut up for you.
Damn. That's
so
right.
So which one you want to
roll? Oh, I think... I look, I want to roll that one and try it. Yeah, just for, like, the one time.
I'll do the Russian cream.
I just, to me, it's something interesting about, like, a strawberry flavor that's just, like, you don't really hear that flavor. There's not, like, a strawberry Swisher. No, there's not, like, a really strawberry backwood or anything like that. So, you just tear off the top.
And this is what they look like. They're literally, like, already pre-cut for you.
You know what? This is how I cut my woods.
Yeah, literally.
Like, I have my scissors so and, like, I just cut them exactly like that.
Yeah.
And they look fresh.
I know, huh? They do have stems here and there, but they're not, like, as thick as backwoods. I'm gonna pick the best.
Oh, this thing smells like a chocolate bar.
It does.
Like, definitely, like, the tobacco smell, obviously, you know? But I thought it was gonna have, like, a big, like strawberry smell. Like, you know, kind of like what you get with backwoods. Like, have you smelled banana woods and the packaging? It's, like, the craziest shit ever. No? I love them. I went through, like, two boxes already. But,
so
yeah.
This is what I'm rolling up.
Let me see what you got.
We got the Zote.
You got the Zote by Deep East.
And Wizard Trees.
Shout out. Shout out to the people over there, man. And you know what I'm saying? Y'all know I couldn't come without some motitas. You feel me? So, big shout out to Don Murphos. If you guys haven't followed Don Murphos on Instagram, make sure you guys go follow him on Instagram. We are partnering up to drop motitas together. So, this is, like, my first strain. And I'm super excited about that. The day we drop this strain too is gonna be lit. We're gonna do, like, a meet and greet. We're gonna cash people out. If you're, like, some of the first people to show up, we're gonna be buying you stuff in line and everything. So, like, you know.
I'm like, cashing out.
Yeah, we gonna come in with some money and buy people stuff. You feel me? So, like, I've done it before for, like, other people's products and everything, but this is, like, my strain. So it's, like, important for me that people really get their hands on it.
Definitely.
And try it, you know. So that's gonna be going down. So make sure you guys go follow Don Murphos on Instagram, DM him, be like, yo, we're ready for the drop, bro. Like, what's up? Let's make it happen. Yeah. So, like, to open the packaging, guys, by the way,
like,
you could twist it out, or you gotta, like hot Cheeto bag it. You know what I'm saying? All right, you guys, so we actually officially finished rolling them, so we're gonna let you guys choose, like, which one you guys think is best. Let me just clean mine up, because, like, it low-key caught some crumbs right now that I laid it back on the tray.
I told him this isn't my best job, but it's good enough.
I feel like mine was, like, mid, too. Like, I wasn't, like, too happy with mine, but...
7 out of 10.
Yeah, I'm gonna give mine, like, a fucking 6. This is mine.
Here, compare it.
Yeah, I was telling her, I was like, I feel like I roll mine like a cone.
Yeah, it's a little thicker on the end.
Yours is definitely longer, though.
Is it?
Like, put them right under... Yeah, look. Like, by a little bit, yeah.
But yours is chunkier.
I like how yours is, like, one size, though. Like, all the way through. You know what I mean? What? Somebody's car is, like, broken down behind us and shit. Yeah, look.
Oh, shit.
But all right, we're going to get into it, man. But what's your favorite song? We got to, like, throw a little sum in there. Mm-hmm. I had to let her get her favorite song in there. She gonna spark hers up. And when you said you got the Zope lit up, and then which one was this? This is the Russian Cream.
So how'd you like it when you're rolling it?
I feel like way easier to roll than a wood. Even easier on your tongue. Like just like licking it and stuff. Yeah, like it doesn't burn your tongue. The leaf was like pretty good overall. You know what? It's actually so like fresh that you have to kind of account for it in a way. Like you have to like roll it a little bit tighter and like stretch the leaf out a little bit more. So I feel like it's thinner. That's the best way to describe it. So it's a little more like flimsy, and you gotta, I feel like you gotta bar it more for sure.
Yeah.
It requires a little bit of bars. We're gonna open this thing up. So what's up? So where are you from? Where were you born and stuff?
I'm from Oakland, California. Born in Oakland, California.
You were born in Oakland? Oh, yeah.
Raised in Oakland, California. Yeah. I just recently moved, like, a city, like, next door to Oakland. But I'm still in the area, you know. Home is home. I love the Bay. Ain't nothing like it.
Wow. This
especially
tastes so good.
Oakland, huh?
This tastes crazy. I honestly really can't taste the leaf.
Like, you really can. It's so smooth.
Mm-hmm. No crazy like aftertaste or anything like that. Like,
yeah.
I do feel like the leaf itself though is like way more delicate than anything else.
Yeah, it's super thin.
You gotta really like hold it gentle. That's one thing I hate about like rolling things like this. Like when you're in a crowd of 4 or 5,
yeah,
it's always gonna be like 2 or 3 people that are gonna like squeeze it or like just like bite it too hard or put their lips on it too hard at the end, and like you're like, yo. It's like you barely gotta like grab it, like
on it too hard.
Yeah, to give it to you like all wet and shit. Like, yo, you damn your deep throat of the damn blunt.
For real. Straight licked it. Yeah, when I'm in public though, I don't like passing my blunt. I be licking my shit.
Mm-hmm. Yo, people look at me like I'm rude, or like random people be like, "Can I hit it?" And when I say no, they're like. But I'm like, bro, I don't even know you. Like
bro,
no offense, but I don't know where your mouth has been. Bro. I rolled this. This is my stuff. Like,
actually, COVID is actually still going around. So
even like before COVID, I was still like, that's just weird to me.
It is.
And it's not like a stingy thing. It's just simply like that's clutch. She could just put her nail into it.
Just tuck it. That's in so the clutch. End right quick.
I think it's too bright coming in. Huh? Too much light.
So we don't get no Scooby snacks.
No, that's clutch because I always have to do that, but I have to like use keys and stuff. You know what I mean? My bad, guys. I'm gonna get the lighting a little better in here. But yeah, no, that's what's up. No, honestly though, like right now, like taste 10 out of 10. As far as like the actual leaf itself, I definitely think it takes like, you gotta have some bars. You can't be like a mid roller and try to roll this because this is not something easy to roll. Airflow is good though. On yours?
Definitely. We're about to make 2 blunts right now. Woods with no water.
Oh no, come on.
I know, I forgot to bring some.
Come on.
Oh, say less.
Come on. Yeah, I got this. It's cold too.
I thought that said Huncho. I'm like, okay.
Huncho? Nah. It's Umo. Shout out Umo.
That's your friend?
Mm. I know them. They're like a company like out there in LA and shit.
So, where are you from?
I'm from Vallejo, born in Stockton, but I don't ever really tell people, like, oh, I was born in Stockton because people expect me to be, like, had grown up out there, but I didn't.
Are you embarrassed?
Am I embarrassed I didn't grow up in Stockton?
No, like, are you embarrassed to say that you were born in Stockton?
Nah, it's just that, like, I don't feel like, it's hard for me to, like, I feel like I almost was born in Vallejo because I grew up my whole life in Vallejo. Mm-hmm. Like, all I know is Vallejo.
Okay.
So, like, if I go to Stockton, I don't know where I'm at.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? Even today, I go out there and I'm like, I'm GPSing. And in Vallejo, I know Vallejo like the back of my hand. Like, it's just different. It's more home, like, you know? But yeah, no, shout out Stockton. Got love for Stockton. I got a lot of people that support me in Stockton. I was out in Stockton last night eating at BJ's. And this guy, like, looked back at me. But I was talking about hats. So I thought he looked back at me because of the hat. And he DM'd me and he was like, dude, you were at BJ's yesterday. And I was like, oh, that's dope.
Oh, that's lit.
You know? Yeah, so I get a lot of love in Stockton for sure. Yeah. But yeah, so I'm from Vallejo. And yeah. I lived in LA like for like 2 years, like not that long ago, and I just barely came back like a year ago.
By the way, this is our first time meeting you guys. If you're wondering why we're asking, like, where you from?
Yeah, literally. Like, we just met a couple minutes ago.
It's good vibes, though.
Is, I just feel like people from the Bay can, like, click.
For
like,
sure. Definitely.
We're very, it's like a very vibe. Yeah. Like, everybody's very, like, we're social, very social, you know, social. Social. That's not in there.
And, like, there's so much culture over here, you know? We're hella diverse.
This city, specifically Berkeley, is, like, one of the most diverse in the Bay Area. Like, right next to, like, San Francisco, you get, like, the hippies. Like, you get, like, all kinds of people here. Like, you know what I mean? But, yeah, I hope everybody's doing good. I hope you guys are vibing with us. You know, let me know in the comment section. How was you guys' day? You feel me? How's everything going for you guys in life? What do you like? I never went to college. Well, I did go to college, actually, for like a year. The community college. But would you ever want to be, like, part of, like, a sorority or
That's
something?
That's funny, because like, me and my friend were literally just talking about this, like, yesterday.
For real?
Yeah, we're like, damn, imagine we were in a sorority, college. Like, what college would you go to? It'd be lit, you know? Because it's, like, a whole different environment. Like, you're just around people your age all the time.
Yeah.
Like, parties all the time.
Yep.
I'd be probably kind of sick of seeing the same people all day, every day. Because outside, who knows?
I would, like, want it, but I just don't know how I, like, think about living with people. Because I'm kind of, like, I get irritated, like, living, like, with people. Because, yeah. Like, you know what I mean? Things aren't where you leave them, or, like, shit's dirty and you have to clean, whatever. Yeah. Vice versa. But it's just, like, it's a lot, you know? And I just feel like, to me, it's like, yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I live alone, too, so.
Yeah, it'd be hard to live with, like, people and stuff.
I love my personal space, like.
Mm-hmm. Same. Tell me about it. You got a song? We're just going to alternate song choices here.
Okay.
So you guys get two different vibes.
I'm the ghetto and you're the bison.
I was telling her, I was like, I don't really listen to, like, a lot of English music, you know? But but I used to, though. Like, before, yeah. When I was in high school, I didn't listen to no Spanish music, like, at all.
Yeah.
I feel like it's just kind of like, when, like, the corridos, like, that are out now, like Fuerza and them, like, started coming out, like, I was like, oh, this shit's dope.
Yeah, like, when I first hop in the car, I'll slap some English music. But if I'm, like, at the ranch, I'll slap some Spanish music.
Cause oh, she's in the ranch a lot, so talk about that, actually. Like, I see that you like to, you have a horse?
Yeah, so I own a horse. He's a quarter Frisian and part Spanish, too. The ranch is in Hayward, and basically I just ran out of stall and, you know,
that's
pay
cool.
Monthly rent or whatever, but they keep him there, they feed him. But I have to, like, feed him extra food, so I be going, like, every other day and feeding him.
Damn, we gotta do a vlog. We gotta do a rancho vlog.
Yes, we should.
That's gonna be lit.
I was literally on a trail ride, literally.
I'll bust out las botas and shit, you know what I mean?
That's all I wear when I'm there.
That's what's up. That's cool. Yeah, I see a lot on your Instagram that you, like, like, you post your horse and stuff, and I was like, okay. I wouldn't, like, off seeing your Instagram, I wouldn't think you were, like, into being in a rancho and stuff like that. Like,
it's funny because when I was, like, younger, I used to go to, like, bailes all the time and, like, shit like that with banda. But I think it's because I didn't have friends anymore who, like that type of vibe no more. So I was like, who do I even go with?
Mm.
So I just, like, stopped fucking with it for a while. But once I got a horse. I was at the ranch a lot, so, you know, that's, like, literally the vibe there all the time, and it'd be lit.
Yeah, I was just telling her, I was like, I feel like it's just up to recently that, like, being Latino is starting to be, like, cool in a way, like, you know, it's like, I feel like we're just changing a lot of the way people viewed Latinos for a long time, like, and it's pretty cool. It feels dope to be living it and be part of it, to be honest, because there's so much people I meet that are like, yo, you know, you inspire me to do what you do or to be do YouTube and stuff like that, and I'm like, that's dope, like.
Like, this is my first YouTube video, so I'm kind of shy, but I was like, I kind of wanted to start getting into YouTube, so I was like, this is a good start, you know, doing a collab with somebody who's already on it, especially who's into the shit that I'm into, you know, like smoking weed, like doing reviews.
I feel that's why the vibe is easy, like, because this is what we do already, like.
Literally. Like, this is what we do for a living.
That's right. This is the Strawberry Dream with the motitas. So this is your first time trying motitas?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, I feel happy that I'm going to be the first one to introduce you to it. So this thing's thick, man. I'm really holding the lighter there, trying to get it to get going because it's thick.
I don't want to box up because I'm already high as fuck.
Jesus, let's put the windows down. Yo, yeah, the first one smacked me too. I'm feeling it. But yeah, and this one's about to hit us like right up the alley too. So destroy the like button.
For real.
We're really getting faded for y'all. But okay, break it down to me. Taste. What are we working with right here?
Honestly, right now I can only taste the wrap.
I was thinking the same thing actually. I was like, it still has the flavor a lot of like the leaf. I couldn't really get it. But I think the other leaf, I right away like honestly liked the taste of the leaf. I feel like it had an easier taste than this flavor, you know?
It did.
Because the other one was like right off the bat, I was able to taste the strain.
It tastes good though.
There we go. Actually, I got more flavor this time.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We gotta push it in. Who's the Tuña? Tuña. This wrap is definitely harsher. I almost feel like we should have rolled one in here so you could taste it with this leaf.
Did you cut some wood, paper off?
No.
You just rolled the whole thing? So you overlap?
Yeah.
Oh, hell no.
You think that's why it tastes so harsh?
Yeah.
Damn. Yeah, you see?
You don't ever, like, rip off?
Yeah, like, I do, but I usually have, like, my scissors and stuff like that.
Okay. So you're just like, fuck it.
But I was just like, yeah. I was like, whatever, you know? Yeah, but no, it's definitely not whatever. Harsh. We're going to have to roll one in a J for sure for you to taste that. But yeah, I guess we use the whole leaf. So she's saying it could be, like, why it's tasting rough.
Yeah, I like to rip off some of the paper or whatever.
I do feel, though, the second time you pass it to me, I feel like it tastes better. Like, I got more, like, flavor out of it.
I can definitely taste the more.
People are going to be like, why did you keep putting the windows up and down? A kid passed by and I was like, oh, shit.
Actually,
all right, how's the roll?
The roll, it's pretty good. I give it a solid 9.
Okay, that's cool. I take that. I feel like the end, I wish I had scissors because I would have like packed the end in more and then would have cut it like good to the tip. Like, you get what I'm saying? But we're working with what we got. And I didn't cut the leaf. I usually always cut the leaf, especially with woods and stuff. But I do think these are, like, easier on your lungs than woods.
Yeah, they are.
Mm-hmm. Woods are definitely, like, a lot harsher.
Mm-hmm. They're not, like, wrapped around the tobacco either, so it's just more convenient.
Yeah. Easier to roll, faster, fresh, you know?
But overall, the motitas is pretty good. I give it a solid 9, too.
We're going to roll one for her in a J. Actually, here, you're going to take that, and you're going to roll yourself a J. Okay. You know what I'm saying? And then you're going to tell me how that tastes. But I think that's going to be, like, where you're really going to see what it is.
Yeah.
Because it's, like, definitely more flavorful in the paper. You get to taste, like, all the terps. Because it has, like, two flavors. It's interesting. It's, like, when you hit it, you get one flavor. When you blow it out, you get another one, and you're like, whoa. But they're both fire, so you're gonna have to give that a shot. What do you roll with papers?
Huh?
What kind of papers do you use
Vibes.
To roll? Vibes, that's right. What pack?
Huh?
What pack? What color pack?
I'm cool. I'm
you good? Hi. Oh, we got a top.
Yeah.
All right, that's what's up, though.
Yeah.
She's hitting. When she said she liked the multitas, she liked the roll. Yeah, let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section.
Are you close
to her? Well, you don't want to end it anymore?
No.
Yeah. We're out, you guys.
Bye.